Hello and welcome to our food studio here in Fife. I'm Wendy Barry from Scottish Food Guide, and today we're going to look at the fruits, vegetables and wild foods that are on Scotland's Ark of Taste. And you can see at the moment we're filming this in September and it's apple season. So it's apples everywhere, and we have quite a number of varieties on Scotland's Ark of Taste that we'll look at in a moment. Also here you've got some potatoes. The bright pink one is the Highland Burgundy Red, and the one beneath is the Shetland Black. More about potatoes later. And last but not least here, Prestonfield rhubarb. The Prestonfield rhubarb has an interesting story because Alexander Dick, who was the grandson of the Lord Provost who built Prestonfield, he was the first to cultivate rhubarb in Scotland and brought the seeds over from Russia, and he staked his entire medical career on the fact that he believed there was great medicinal benefits in rhubarb, and indeed he sent some off to the Pope to help him cure his ills. We don't have a record of the response of the Pope, but we know he got the Prestonfield rhubarb. So you can bag up rhubarb, of course, when it's in season and stick it in the freezer, or you can make some lovely chutneys and jams. There's a rhubarb jam here. Lovely rich rhubarb jam with the Prestonfield rhubarb. And there's also a chutney here with a James Grieve apple in it as well. So the apples in Scotland grow very well, and particularly the Clyde Valley and the Carse of Gowrie are world famous for their apples, and many varieties dating back to the 17th, 18th, 19th century have been cultivated in those two particular valleys, and indeed in many other parts of Scotland as well. And at the moment we've got a few on the Ark. We've got the James Grieve, which we've got here. We've dried some James Grieve, and we've dried some Bloody Ploughman, which is an interesting story. It's one of the ones from the Carse of Gowrie, and the story goes that farm worker stole some apples from the estate and was shot by the gamekeeper. And when his poor widow had his body returned, he still had the scrumped apples in his pockets, and she threw them away in disgust onto the cowp, and they grew. And the Bloody Ploughman apples are a beautiful blood red colour, and indeed many of them, but not all of them, have got these veins of red through them. These are pretty red, but sometimes you cut into a Bloody Ploughman and it doesn't have the red vein, but it doesn't mean it's not a Bloody Ploughman. There's the Cambusneth and Pippin, which is one of the Clyde Valley ones. And indeed, we've just been having a wonderful few days at Megginge Castle, where there's the National Heritage Orchards, the most incredible collection of Scottish heritage apples, and indeed cider apples, and indeed pears. So we've been studying these and researching them in collaboration with Megginge, and there will be more of those coming onto the Ark very soon and into next year. So that's very exciting. So keep an eye out for these new varieties of apples and pears joining on the Ark. So we've dried some of them, chutneyed, jammed, and also made apple butter, where you quarter and core the apples, you don't need to peel them, cook them slowly so they get a wonderful moist pulp, pass it through a sieve, and put that lovely sieved apple puree back in the pan and slow cook it. Taste it. It probably needs a little bit of sugar, but only add what you need. It can be a little bit tart because we use this for pork, we use it in our breakfast yogurt, so it can be used for sweets and savoury things. It's absolutely delicious. Some of you may know the Jersey butter, which is on the Ark of Taste, and it's very black, and this is not, but the Jersey butter has other ingredients and cooks for about 24 hours. This only cooks for about an hour, but you get that lovely caramelised toffee colour, and it's really delicious. Now, there are some great heritage potatoes on the Ark of Taste in Scotland, and Scotland is world famous for its seed potatoes. They don't have blight. They've got a great reputation for being very healthy and are exported. And there's some great heritage varieties. That Highland Burgundy Red you saw in the picture is absolutely pink as it could be, and it stays that colour when cooked. So if you have a passion for pink, or you just like a delicious potato, this is a great one to grow. Another good one to grow is the Shetland Black, a really old variety with some lovely veining, as you can see. They're a floury potato, and the colours tend to go when you boil them, but not if you bake them wedges or sliced in the oven. or roast them. They keep these nice little colours going. And there's a couple of potatoes that are coloured skins, but quite creamy inside. The Edsel Blue, which this is, and the Arran Victory, which was created to commemorate the end of World War I in 1918. A delicious potato. The Edsel is quite a fluffy potato, which will take on the flavours of the wonderful gravies and stews that you might be cooking. There are other potatoes that are on the Ark, and we're right now working on the Epicure that we hope will be joining the Ark quite soon, and some other potatoes. So again, watch this space for some more potatoes. The Gypsy Yethan potato is another one that's already on the Ark. So some lovely varieties there. We've got some Scottish juniper. Now, juniper is quite rare in Scotland. I put this down to the lack of grazing animals. You need that holistic approach to sustainable food production, and having animals on the moors, on the hills, is very much part of what that natural cycle needs and helps to encourage the juniper bushes. So when you lose the animals, you lose a lot of the biodiversity, including the juniper bushes. And we pick these, dry them a little bit, not for long, on a plate. Maybe I'll leave them lying around for a week or so. And then pop them in a jar. And they're great crushed lightly, just enough to bruise them and release the flavours. We use them for knackbrod. We use them for juniper butter. We add them to game. They're delicious with herring. So lots of different uses for juniper berries. And they keep very well. Birch sap, or birch water as it's sometimes known, is taken from the birch trees at one time of the year in Scotland, usually in Perthshire, or it could be up in the Highlands where the birch trees thrive. Now, you need to own the birch tree or get permission. You can't just stab a birch tree. And the one person that produces it in Scotland commercially is Birken Tree. But if you have your own in the garden, give it a go. It's slightly sweet with many health benefits and really delicious. I poached pike in it as well, and it was really delicious. We have Isle of Skye sea salt, and this comes straight from Loch Snizort on Skye. Pure, unadulterated fjord, deep inlet on Skye, and there's nothing else added. And the tradition for that, because with the Ark you need the history there, goes back 300 years to salt production in the same place. Only then they used peat pans to fire up, to evaporate the salt, which wouldn't be quite so environmental these days. But what they do use is solar energy, pure sun, nothing else. And it does get sunny on Skye, and it's a beautiful salt. Vegetables. We've got some lovely Musselburgh leeks here. We've grown in our garden. My husband corrected me that we don't thin our leeks. That suggests we bin them. He selectively gives me what I'm allowed to cook. And these ones are still a bit on the thin side. They'll get bigger and bigger. They'll last us right through the winter. We won't need to buy an onion. They're delicious and mellow and really cook very well. And there is no waste. Every inch of this leek will be used. And it's delicious. So they really are great. From when they're spring onion size right through to proper leeks. They're really a lovely, lovely vegetable. And if, like me, you were used to big lumps of dark green stuff in an overcooked soup at school, then these will be a joy for you. You will love leeks again. They grow very well here. They're very hardy. You won't be able to buy them in the shop, but you can easily buy the seeds and grow them yourself. Another one that you can't buy in the shop, but you can buy the seeds, you can get Shetland kale, one of the oldest cultivated vegetables in Scotland, probably Britain. And this is from the Mackenzie's Farm Shop on Shetland. And we've got some planted. They're about this size at the moment. But this is a fantastic picture I took of a really proud specimen on Trondra Croft up on Shetland. So they're really delicious and hardy. So, That's another great vegetable to have. Nothing you see here you can find anywhere near a supermarket. So you don't need to go near a supermarket for anything. Just enjoy growing, enjoy sourcing them from producers, and just enjoy the fact that there's such great flavours. Last but not least, we have got the Colonsay honey. Now, this is Andrew Abrams' honey, and he has Scottish native bees on Colonsay. And the great thing about having an old colony of heritage bees on an island is they can't crossbreed with other things as they could on the mainland. And also on an island, There is no pesticides, no fertilizers. It's pure, unadulterated heath and macher. So this is true terroir. And although maybe a little bit more expensive than most honeys, this is a positive spice. So source it, enjoy it, get a jar sent to you. All these things are available for you to, well, some are a bit more scarce, I suppose, but the availability is all in details on my website for you to see and just celebrate the Arc of Taste. Thank you.